Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. Our topic is the Monmouth County Improvement Authority. This entity works to finance the county's biggest projects and helps out local municipalities as well. Joining me today are Freeholder Serena DiMaso and Improvement Authority Chairman Al Rosenthal. Welcome, both of you. Thanks so much for being here on Monmouth in Focus today.
Good to be here. Get the message out.
Let's start out, you know, with the basics. What is the Monmouth County Improvement Authority?
Well, the Monmouth County Improvement Authority was formed by the Board of Chosen Freeholders in 1986, so we just passed 25 years. And it's an effective way for municipalities to pool their resources in order to buy some big-ticket items. Mm-hmm. They take advantage of the county's AAA rating, and they're able to get a lower-cost interest loan. And it's really a wonderful opportunity for townships. I know when I was the mayor and a committee woman, we took full advantage of the MCIA bonding, and mm-hmm. as well as our Board of Education does the same. And it's truly a super opportunity for the townships.
Absolutely. Now, how does it specifically work, Al?
Well, through the pooling, in other words, if an individual town or some entity wanted to go out for financing on their own, mm-hmm. All their costs, individual costs of the producing of the information, the attorney's fees, we put that all together. And a lot of these towns, because they may need small amounts, we can bind it all together. And with the backing of the AAA rating of the county, the freeholders have made it so that it makes more sense to deal through the Improvement Authority than in any other form. We have the lease program, where every other year they can get equipment and lease it through the Improvement Authority. And then also we take care of their bond anticipation notes. We pull that and make it a complete deal and at tremendous savings. We just did a deal last month, a lease program for over $14 million, where we saved, I think the rate was 2.44 over a 20-year span. Mm. The savings were over $1 million.
And that's the program where six towns participated?
Yes.
Okay.
Right.
So you had said you offer the program, it's every other year?
Every other year on the lease program.
Okay.
And on the pool loan program, we do that every year.
Okay. Now, you mentioned the AAA bond rating. We mentioned that a lot. The Freeholders mentioned that. Specifically, what is a AAA bond rating?
Well, it's the rating that comes down from the Fitch, Moody's, Standard & Poor's, some people know it as S&P, mm-hmm. and it's one of the things we're most proud of because it really shows that we handle our monies effectively, we do what we need to do to make sure that we keep that AAA rating. It is by far one of the best accolades you can get from the rating companies. We've had it solid for 12 years. We were just renewed again this past week. And it just allows participants to borrow money at a lesser rate than they would have if they did it on their own. So it's something to be really proud of.
Absolutely. Now, the county did something new a few years ago?
Yes, because of the problem with the... Before that, we always had the AAA rating, mm-hmm. but we used insurance, bond insurance. And I'm sure most people know most of those companies got into real problems. And some of them defaulted. Some of them got ratings that were very low. So the county came in, and they said, and besides the cost, if you wanted to issue a insurance with the bonds, the cost became very prohibitive. Mm-hmm. So it prevented right. the savings. The county came in and said, use our AAA rating. We got a tremendous savings for the individual towns and entities that wanted to join us. And it all goes back to the freeholders because of their due diligence in keeping that AAA rating has saved all these towns, the Board of Eds, any agencies. It's a tremendous saving. There's no way any town, get that sort of a rate. The savings are humongous.
Right, and that's because the county backs the loans.
Because of their AAA rating.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody wants to buy our bonds.
Right.
Every bond deal we do, we're oversubscribed. People from out of town want to buy our bonds, mm-hmm. banks and everything.
Right.
Because of the rating that we have in this county.
Okay, so when we talk about the county backing loans, why does the county do that? Basically to save money, correct?
Save the people money.
Mm-hmm.
Save the towns.
Mm-hmm.
Lowers their costs.
Mm-hmm.
It's a win-win.
Yep.
For everybody.
It's a win-win for everybody. And the money, you know, what is the money used for?
Well, it could be used for computer equipment. It can be, they need snow plows, police cars, schools. We built schools. We built schools in Howell, new schools, Middletown, mm-hmm. Millstone. Whoever can use the money, whoever needs the money, it would be make sense for them to go to the Improvement Authority. Because as long as, with the backing of the freeholders who have seen this project as so important for savings for everyone, this is the route to go for any town. Nobody can do it for a less cost than we can produce. Remember, we have one part-time employee. In all these years, we've done over $14 billion worth of bonds and leases. We have one part-time employee. We have five commissioners.
They do an excellent.
We get nothing.
They do an excellent job.
And we're proud to do it.
They've also been able to use that money to leverage for open space, and the improved funding mechanism is used for the county's open space program. But as Al said, you know, fire trucks, big ticket items that if the municipalities had to try to go out and buy them on their own would be exorbitant in the probably the interest rate they'd have to pay. And so they going through the county. We've done over 70 transactions since it started. It's an unbelievable program.
So basically, you had mentioned the 70 transactions with a value of more than $1.4
billion.
Dollars.
Mm-hmm. Would it be?
I mean, that's a lot.
That is a lot. That is
over
a lot.
Over 26 years, 25 years, right?
Right.
With a part-time employee.
How do you do it?
We got a great part-time employee.
I was going to say.
And we actually have some really wonderful volunteers. The five commissioners really work very hard.
We put a lot of effort into it.
They do. You know, they go out. They make sure that people know about it. They reach out to the communities and make sure that they know that they can take full advantage of this program. And I don't think there's a municipality, a government agency, or a school board that doesn't know about the program at this point.
That was my next question. How do you get the
word out? We run sometimes like little seminars. Mm-hmm. Like right now we're involved with the help of the freeholders. We're starting a solar project. Mm-hmm. That could turn out to be a tremendous savings for school boards, utilities, municipal buildings. We've been working on that project for almost a year now. Mm-hmm. We're coming down to a point now where we think we can put it together and we can show real savings for the towns. The cost of, you know, all this electricity and everything has been getting very high.
Right.
And if we could switch over to the solar projects where it makes sense, over the years, the savings could be tremendous. Mm-hmm. But before we jump into it, we're strictly with the direction of the freeholders. Once we get all the numbers together and the projects together, then we'll all work together and see whether it can work. Mm-hmm. And if it does, it'll be a tremendous saving for a lot of towns.
You know, in this economy, you know, especially you talk about schools, you talk about school overcrowding, school funding, you know, being pulled, you know, the budget's not passing. How important is it, you know, that you have this money to, like you said, you built a school in Howell, you built mm-hmm. a school in Millstone.
Two schools, two, three schools in Howell.
Yeah, I mean, that is.
And in Middletown. Mm-hmm. Right, and Clarksburg.
It is extremely important. As you may or may not know, boards of education can't bond on their own, so they do need the support of the township committees. So that fosters a relationship between boards of education and township committees, mm-hmm. and then that grows into a relationship with the county. So it's really a wonderful opportunity for everyone all around, and the person that benefits the most is the Monmouth County taxpayer, because the dollars that are saved in the long run are always passed along to the taxpayer. And just last month, we refinanced a whole bunch of bonds, and we saved, you know, $6 million, which is going to be passed along to the taxpayers. I mean, mm-hmm. that's a significant savings in these economic times.
Mm-hmm. Even here at Brookdale, we do funding. We're in a process right now of refunding Brookdale's debt, mm-hmm. and they'll save, it'll be savings in the millions. Taking their debt that they took out, say, 10 years ago when the rates were 5% or 6%, we're going to redo it, call it back in, redo it at maybe 2.5% or less than 3%.
Right.
That's hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars that the taxpayers who are funding and supporting Brookdale through the Board of Chosen Freeholders, that's savings for everybody.
Absolutely. So it's safe to say that the Improvement Authority and the AAA bond rating are definitely a benefit to the taxpayers.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And there are so few, there are not many counties in this state that have the AAA rating.
Absolutely. Now, Al, you are the chairman of the Improvement Authority.
Yes.
How long have you been the chair for?
I've been the chairman about 4 years.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've been on the committee, I'd say, about 16, 17 years.
Right.
I've been a commissioner.
How have you seen it change throughout the years?
Well, I think the biggest change is that towns are starting to understand. They used to be like, we have our own bond guy, we have our own attorney, but they're starting to realize that those costs are so far out of whack compared to what we can do. That there's really, and there are a few towns, I'm sorry to say, and a few Board of Eds that are still haven't seen the light.
Right.
And
right.
it bugs me. Mm-hmm. Why? I mean, it's so easy.
Right.
Cost we do every measure. We put everything together, and it works. We have a proven record of you tremendous savings.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And Serena, I just wanted to congratulate you. You know, first few months as a freeholder.
Thank you
Monmouth County
much.
Freeholder. Obviously, lots of local government experience coming from Homedale. Do you see a big difference between local government and county government?
Not really. Honestly, it's mostly all the same thoughts, plans, ideas. You know, we all want to make a better place. You want to make Monmouth County the best place to live, work, and raise a family. That was our goal in Homedale, to make sure that Homedale was one of the best places to live, work, and raise a family.
Mm-hmm.
So the goals are all the same. It's just, where Homedale had a $20 million budget, the county has a $500 million
right.
budget. So the numbers, the mm-hmm. decimal point being moved so far over
right.
Is a big change. But
right.
otherwise, we have a phenomenal staff at Monmouth County. As Alice said, you know, you had one part-time employee for the Monmouth County Improvement Authority. We're really working on with phenomenal people, you know, from one end of the county to the other. So it really makes my job very easy to
All
just
right.
govern.
Well, great job with Monmouth County Improvement Authority as well as the Board of Chosen Freeholders for this initiative. Thanks so much for joining us today, both of you.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
That
Thank
is all the time we
us.
Have for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. For more information about the Monmouth County Improvement Authority, you can log on to www.visitmonmouth.com. Thanks for joining us. Have a great day, everyone.